Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the next episode of City Skylines with me, Biffa. And here we are in the city of Teaport. So I hope you had a fantastic weekend and a fantastic Monday, because it's probably now Tuesday. And we've got tons of plans for today's episode. We have unlocked a lot of stuff while you've been away. So we've upgraded our university. Here we go. We can see the little pop-up here showing us what we've unlocked next, which is fantastic. And our truck's got stuck in some traffic down here. Oh my goodness me, I think we need to try and do something about this. And we've unlocked the next two levels on our amusement park as well. I need to let you know the name that's been chosen for that. But before we get into those things, I want to just sort out this little problem that we've got over here. Let's come out of that view and take a look. So we're constantly getting traffic down here because of this. So our basketball arena is having so many visitors. Oh, jumpy game. And they all want to jump in their car. And go out on this road here. I'm just wondering here, we've got dedicated turning lanes. We've got giveaway. We must have giveaway on this road. We do, and they're still just going because there's so many cars. I'm just wondering actually whether we could just force them to turn right instead. Where would they go? If we force them all to turn right, let's try that. I bet they would get out a lot quicker. Let's change this road at the end back to a normal road like that. And then we use this tool here, grab that and say, no, only turn right, and then see what happens. Let's just speed that up a sec. Let's look this way. And there's not that many cars that come down this way. There we go. So they're now getting out four or five at a time, much quicker. What I might just do as well, actually, is change our little setup here. So I could say that that has to go there, that has to go there, and that has to go there. So that means these cars can constantly go because they're always going to go into this lane. Is there any other nodes nearby? The next node's down there. They can change. Plenty of nodes for changing lanes if they want to before they get down to that junction. And look, all pouring out, all super quick. Getting a little bit more traffic down here. Now, what I want to make sure they're not doing is something stupid somewhere else. So let's just use the in-game tool. Routes, select this road. There we go. Oh, there's so many people coming and going. Oh, look at that. Another year has gone past. Excellent. So we're campus attractiveness, extra works, renowned, which was the same as before, but that was an upgrade. Couple more works there. Another sports trophy. Excellent. So loads of people are coming down here, and then they're coming round there, sort of turning round, and then, look, they're turning round at the end of the road here. I knew that's what was going to happen. They were going to find some stupid spot to turn around. I just need to put a little roundabout in somewhere, and I think it's going to go in here. It's just going to have to, isn't it? Yeah, let's just do it. So we're going to have, I'm going to go for a three-lane roundabout, because there's two lanes coming in. There will be two lanes coming in here. I'm going to change it back again. And there's two lanes coming in there. So we're going to grab our three-lane road. There we go. Get that back on again. Let's press the right button to make that a teeny tiny bit smaller. I'm hoping that's just going to go underneath there. Just. And then if we use the move it mod, we can do that. Let's move that a little bit closer. And that fits in nicely, doesn't it? Yeah, that's good. Let's get rid of the move it, roundabout mod. And then we'll just make sure that this is set up. There we go. And then actually, before I do that, I'll put this back in. Two lanes out, one lane in. Yeah, that's good. And then we'll just make sure this is okay. I think that shouldn't make any difference. And I reckon, let's put it this way round. I reckon that is going to solve that. Excuse me. Did you hear that frog? There's a frog living in the trees. I'm hoping that is going to solve the problem. It might take a few minutes to go down because a load of traffic now coming from the left. But yeah, let's just leave that going and see if that helps. Hey, look at that. Barely 2-3 minutes gone and all the traffic has cleared up. So we know it can deal with a backlog of a huge amount of traffic up there and a huge amount of traffic down here. I'm hoping that the next time, let's just have a look. When is the next match? 19th of the 11th, 21:03. My goodness me, we're living in the future. So we've got a long time to go before that happens, but I'm pretty sure that will be okay. All right, well, let's just have a quick look at our university. We're now on level 3, which is fantastic. Renowned. To get to the next level, we've got to get up to 900 attractiveness and another academic work. So that just happens every year. We'll get one or two academic works. So hopefully, if we can get up to 900 attractiveness before that, before the next tick over for the year, we will be golden. So I can never remember which one of these we're using. University campus area, that is what we're using. And we have some extra stuff on here, which is great. So university academic statue number one. The university commencement office. What does that do? Required to hold a visible graduation ceremony. Ah, brilliant. A math club, a university light. Oh, what does a math club do? It's just attractiveness. Attractiveness, yeah. This one is student capacity, the library, the university fountain. Pretty sure we had that before, and cafeteria. Yeah, okay, that's good. Did have a couple of comments about our university area. I'll just mention that while we're there. So I've got my university area, as you can see, drawn here and going all the way up over here. We can, of course, just disconnect this by carefully doing this. Zip. Let's take all this out. Back down to here. And that will still count that as a connected university. If I hover over this, look, you can see it. Like, what is that? A dead bus route? Why have I got a dead bus route? I was probably going to fix itself. We won't worry too much about that. So is there something we could fit up here to help these guys and girls over this way? And we could fit maybe up against this little spot here. I think that would be nice. I think the maths club is small enough to go in here. And if we pop it up against this road, we're going to lose that fence. Well, that's fine because I deleted all the other fences anyway. And I was going to say it's probably going to terraform the land a tiny bit. Now, how do you fancy climbing up those stairs to get into your math club? Let's come around this way. Yeah, maybe not so good. So let's turn that around the other way. Put it up against there. And then maybe let's use... Why is that so high? Let's use the move it mod to get that back down lower again. I think that works better up against there. Good. That's okay. So we'll add that in there. And that's going to increase the overall attractiveness of Smarty Pants University. So what are we trying to get up to? Trying to get up to 900, weren't we? Yeah, so it's 720. I don't want to overload it with things that are going to cost a ton of money. The commencement stuff. Now, that would be fantastic to put right over here, I reckon. If we could squeeze this in. They're already cheering for the commencement office. There we go. There, so we're going to see them all in there at the end of the year. So we'll look out for that. 840. And then let's just pick one more. I love the library. That is a big, stately looking building. I think that should have its own little spot over here. Yes. Now, what I want to do is grab this path here. I'm going to sort of do a straight path like that. We're going to curve that one in. Okay, let's turn off node snapping. We're going to curve that one in like that there. We're going to curve that one in like that there. So it's got its own little area. Let's go back over. Oh, what have we got? School of Medicine. All right, we'll get to that when it's big enough. Where is it? Here we go. University Library. Yep, and that is going to go there. That looks nice. I like that. I like that a lot. And then could we sort of do something with this little area here? Maybe a few little nice trees or something would look good. Why not? Let's see. Yeah, there we go. Just a little something like that. And you're going to get some nice views out of the library as well, over the city and over the river area that we've got there. That'll be good. I don't think we're going to be too far off. 870. Oh, we're so close. So one more little thing. The university fountain. I thought we already had that, but maybe we... Oh, I know where. We had something up here, didn't we? What was this one? That was the university fountain. Yeah, okay. So maybe we could pop another little university fountain in here somewhere. I just want to check that we've got enough student capacity before... So eligible 14,000. Capacity 7,600. Wow. Wow. I thought... And how many students have we got here? So they're not all coming here. I think they're not all travelling from various areas. Okay. So I think maybe just another little fountain over here would be fine. Just to sort of finish off this area. So what I'm going to do is this. We go. I think that's okay. Nice little enclosed area. So when you come through the tunnel from the other side, you can nip into here, enjoy this nice little fountain. And I think that should take us, yes, enough attractiveness, enough students. So it's literally just waiting for the year to end. And then we'll be able to unlock the next level. Fantastic. Well, let's come over here then and have a look. The strawberry experience is at level 4. Again, we need to get this entertainment level up. We're still making some money, which is fantastic. And we have some great name suggestions, which we will come to in a moment. So thank you for those. And we've unlocked some new things. The furthest we got in the last video was the rotating teacups. Absolutely love those. Here they are down here. This is like everybody's favourite ride when they come here. Absolutely brilliant. So now we have lots of other options. We have the swinging boat, which isn't too large, which is good. We have the House of Horrors with that head sticking up. We have, what's this one here? Bumper cars, again, not too big. Drop tower ride. And we have the pendulum ride. Now, we do have coming up the Ferris wheel and the roller coaster, which I'd like to have. Why does my game jump like that? That's very annoying. Like to have maybe the roller coaster over here and one of the other big ones over here. I think we could use this area down here as well to fit some stuff in. That would be a good idea. So what I'm going to do first of all is, let's pop back into this one. We're going to grab our tree line park and we're going to see if we can turn Prop and Tree Anarchy off before I forget. And we are going to run this along the coast over here, just a touch, so we can sort of use this area. I want to just sort of come through the trees. Not quite sure how much space we're going to need. I'm going to bring this one out straight to there, and then we'll see what we need to work on. So let's decide what is going to go where. I'm wondering whether this one would be good over here, because it's going to have the head poking up out of the trees. Which I think would be quite good. Let's just give that a little area of its own. We're going to take this out like that. And we're going to pop... Where is it? Here it is. Pop this one. Let's just pop it on the end over there. There we go. Look at that. Imagine walking through the trees and you see this spinning pumpkin head poking up through the trees. That is brilliant. I love that. That's great. And then what can we put alongside that? The bumper cars, which I think could be quite good. So let's... Ooh. There we go. Excellent. The bumper cars, that fits in nicely. Let's just move this little bit over here. Maybe not so far out of the way. There we go. Like that. And I'm also going to lift up this road. So if we go shift, shift, control H, there we go. So it's all the same height. Nice. Good, good, good. What have we got next? What have we got next? Oh, got some of these big ones. I want this, the drop tower. Where do I want that? And that is giving a huge, look at that bonus that it's giving. Entertainment value 120. I'd like that. Maybe over on the end here. I squeeze that in here. So actually come over the bridge. If I turn Anarchy off, it wouldn't do it. If I put Anarchy on, it's like, yep, we can do it. And then I'm going to use the Move It mod just to move that back a touch. And I think that's going to be okay right there. How about that? If that isn't going to catch your eye when you're coming down the highway... Look at that. Mummy, can we go to the strawberry experience? I've heard its name's going to change very soon. But yeah, look, if that doesn't catch your eye, I don't know what will. That is brilliant. Let's just take a quick look at these mad guys and girls that are going on this ride. There they go. I'll have a quick sip of tea while they're going up. Bit jerky there. Hope they didn't snap their necks on the way up. We'll find out when they come back down again. Whoa, look at that. Good gravy. That'd be scary. And then did I miss something here? Yeah, we've got a swinging boat. That's only quite small. Like I said, I want to leave this space up here. But we could have the swinging boat right on the edge over here. So if we take... Can I get a third road out of there? Oh, look at how I can. So we're going to go to there. Okay, that's just getting annoying. Let's turn off the road guidelines. We're going to go to there. And then we're going to do that. Oh, that's close. And then I'm going to move this a bit. Our little... I don't know what this is. Broken down thing. We'll move that over like that. And I reckon that is just going to be enough room to get the swinging boat in. Right on the end. Hooray! There we go. Look at that! Smack your face into a tree. Oh, mommy! Yeah, let's move a couple of these trees out of the way. Let's get this big one here and pop that up against there. Let's move this foliage over here somewhere. Not that one. This one. Yes, there we go. Can you hear it creaking? It just sounds so dangerous. I love it. I think that's okay. There we go. Oh, hang on a minute. Look, all of this is overlapping it as well. Let's just... Excellent. There we go. That's good. These trees are built into it. So, hooray. There we go. So we've got the swinging boats. We've got this space over here for some of the larger ones that are coming up. Bumper cars we've got in. Oh, pendulum ride. How big is that? Oh, that is quite a large one, isn't it? I reckon that could go in down here as well. We've got the space. So if we just get prop and tree anarchy, would that let me... No, I want collision. Oh, what was the button for collision? Oopsie. Oh, I remembered it. If we go... Actually, we probably don't need collision. Yes, we do. If we pop that in there... Oh, darn it. And then, of course, all the trees get in the way. So, yeah. Let me sort this out. There we go. All sorted. And it's barely brushing these trees. Who hasn't been on a ride at a theme park where your feet don't brush some trees on the way past and you possibly lose your shoes? I've been there. I've done it. So that we're going to have it here as well. Oh, excellent. And I think that was everything we've unlocked. So the pendulum, the big pointy thing, the bumper cars, yeah, the spinning turnip, the swinging boat, yeah. So we're waiting for these last couple here. So, I mean, we're well, oh, we'd say well over, just over the entertainment value needed. So we need 2,000. We've got 2,040. Visitors, we need 10,000. That's just a waiting game. So let me leave this run until we get to level 5, and I'll run off and I'll tell you what the most voted for name was to rename the strawberry. Oh, the strawberry experience is sort of growing on me now. But let's pick the name that you guys said was going to be really cool. So back in a sec. Okay, because I like the strawberry experience so much, we're going to keep that, but we're also going to add Tivoli strawberry experience. Now, for those that don't know, and I didn't know, Tivoli, spelled T-I-V-O-L-I, is in Denmark, and it is the second oldest... I'm pretty sure it's in Denmark. I've just read it like 3 seconds ago. My brain's forgotten already. Second oldest amusement park, opened in 1843 or something like that, which is absolutely fantastic. So, yeah, we'll name it that. And the person who gave us that name was Steeny. Steiny. Steny. Yeah, you know how you pronounce your name. You know who you are. So thank you for that suggestion. So... if any of that information was wrong, I'm sure you'll all find out by the 32,000 comments about it below. Okay, so I'm going to hang on. I'm just laughing at this head. I'm going to hang on and wait for the level 5. Oh, while we're waiting for that, look what we just hit. We now have Acclaimed, which is fantastic. Up from Renowned in Smarty Pants University, which has unlocked the auditorium, the bookstore, and the laboratories, whatever you want to call them. A couple more academic works. which is brilliant. And here we go. The Tivoli Strawberry Experience has reached level 5. We get our roller coaster and our Ferris wheel. Look, they're still making money, which is brilliant. I'm pretty sure people are using this as a cut through somehow, because we've got an entrance here, which, you know, it's not too far from the ferry. And then they're cutting through to down here, maybe? I don't know. But we're going to be building up other bits over here anyway, so I'm sure people are going to use it for a cut through. An unintended, excellent side effect. That wasn't what we were going for, but we've got it anyway. So, Ferris wheel. I wanted these to go down on this one. So, let's just get it facing the way I want. So, something like that. And then next to that, can we fit in the roller coaster? I know that's pretty huge. Ooh, mama. No. Okay, we can extend this island a bit. I think that's what we're going to have to do. So let's pause the game and then see what we can do. Let's grab our tools. We're going to grab our economy. Nope. We're going to grab this one here. Brush strength down a bit, brush size up a bit. And we're going to level the terrain. So we're going to grab whatever size that is. And we're going to just sort of push this out a bit. Can always do a little bit more monkeying around with it afterwards. How big is this going to need to be? Yeah, so this bit on the end here is going to really have to go out, isn't it? So let's just take that right out like that. I'm going to move that rock because, you know, we're all four rocks on this playthrough. And let's grab that again. There we go. Plenty of space. It's certainly going to overhang a little bit. Do I want it facing this way? So we've got the building on the left as we look at it and the roller coaster sticking out on the right. Well, let's go for there. Nice. And then I'm hoping the entrance was down here somewhere. Let's just have a look. Where's the arrow for the entrance? Yeah, it's going to be along here. So that's okay. I reckon we can stick a little road path, whatnot, down here. And that, there it is. Look, it shows us. So if we come down here. There we go. And we'll get this one. Oh, actually, we're right there by a path. Look at that. Whoa, that path is very high up in the air. So how about we do a bit of maneuvering? Oh, it's going already. Flipping out. They are getting stuck right in. So let's just move this down a bit. Oh, my life. Once again, Biffa has managed to flood the things. I think it's going to sort itself out. I think we'll be okay. I'm going to move this up to this height, actually. There we go. That's better. And then we can just sort of tidy this up a little bit. Okay, so now we've unlocked some extra additions for our university over here. I've just placed the bookstore down, which looks really nice. I do like that. That gives us a couple of extra bonuses in the city and boosts campus attractiveness, and that's a given, tourism attractiveness, and land value, which is really, really good. Now, this one over here, the university laboratories, I'd like to expand our campus area. So we've got our campus here, we've got a little campus down here where we've got some buildings, and all the way up there. I'd like to give these people over here some access to the campus. So if we go into our university section here, so we do have a university all the way over here, just a bog standard one. We have 3,232 students in that. So I think we can shut that down and get another campus over here. So, and use some of these new buildings. So what I'm going to do, just to draw this in, is I'm going to go from... Oh, I forgot we drew this in and took in this whole little area here. Okay, interesting. I'll keep that in mind. I'm going to get that, and I'm just going to... Oh, that ain't going to work. Oh, it still works, even though it's gone off of a square. Okay, good. So actually, what I can do is get that, come all the way around the outside. And does that still count? Yep, it's flashing up there. Good, okay. And then I'm going to take this area in down here. It's not letting me... There we go. I'm going to take this area in down here. Maybe just that spot. How big is this item that we're trying to fit in here, the laboratories? Yeah, that'll fit in there. That's fine. So if we delete this, sorry, students. And then if we take this, if we anarchy that in and then just take a look and see how it looks up against the buildings behind. Just slightly overlapping. So I'm going to move that firehouse. There we go. Just popped it in here between these two walking paths. That'll work good. So now our campus area is expanded over to here. We've already got a bus stop outside. And look at that. We've already got this filling up with students. And it increases. Look at that. Oh, my goodness me. University students in the city. Wow. So even though this adds this little tiny capacity, because that is connected to the whole campus, which is dotted around our city, our overall students is just climbing and climbing and climbing. So we've now got access to all of the students in this area as well, because let's be honest, these guys here were not going to want to travel to all the way over here or here. So that is just brilliant. And then as we saw before, if we wish, we can then... There we go. Let's have that. We can then just disconnect this so we can get rid of those little freaky lines. Zip, zip, zip. And zippity-doo-dah. Excellent. That is cool. Are there any other little spots here that maybe we could add some university buildings in? What? Oh, we've got so much industry we need. What's the next one that unlocks? The auditorium. Auditorium increases student capacity, campus area attractiveness. Yeah, that's fine. That is pretty large, but if we could get that in here. So I bet this is a library. Yeah. And we've got sporty things going on. We've got a high school. And we've got this big tower block in here. I'm just wondering if we could squeeze it in here and get rid of this tower block. What have we got? Supermarket. See, yeah, let's get rid of some of these. Would it fit in there? Yes, it would. So let's get rid of this, 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 and this. Let's dezone that, 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 and that. There we go. We'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of these trees because they're all going to be mostly hidden anyway. We'll leave the ones on the corner. And that should, if we straighten out this road here. So let's put snapping on. Whoa. There we go. And I bet that will fit in now. Do you know what? If we just tap the anarchy key. Oh, not in campus area. That's the problem. Ha ha. So let's get this, extend that over to there, and I bet that'll be it now. Oh, nice. I really want it against this road. Yeah. So it's sort of straight with that. And then what I'm going to do is, so I'm going to turn that off and just move this up on the back. Maybe add a bit of curve back to that again. A little bit. Oh, it's on still. Didn't realize. Yeah, that's fine. There we go. I like it. So let's just check again. Is that going to give us... Let's turn off the move it mods. So our capacity, universities... So this is going to fill up straight away. And again, our universities in the whole of the city are just flying through the roof, which is nuts. But I like the look of that as well. That really goes with the library, doesn't it? Look, let's go into this mode. There we go. That really goes with the library and the school. Perfect, perfect. So let's come all the way back over here again to Smarty Pants University. We're about to get to the end of another year. We've got all the students we need. We've nearly filled up our capacity. I need a sip of tea, and we need to make sure we get the campus attractiveness up another 800. Oh, look, we've got the end of year thing going on over here. They're all chucking their hats in the air. Let's just get a closer look at that quickly before we end up. There we go. Throw those hats. Nice. Okay, you sit down. I'm going to leave it in pause. Before that ticks over to the end of the year, we must get the attractiveness up. Let's see what we can do. And look at that. There we go. Reputation level acclaimed. Oh, darn it. It was the same as last time. What did we miss? Oh, my goodness. We've got to get up to 16 academic works. Oh, my life. To get to the last level. Well, anyway, we can work on that. That's no problem. So I've popped a few more buildings around here in our original campus area. I think these buildings just look fantastic. Loads of dormitories I've put around the place, because if we look at our facts and figures up over here, university, eligible. 15,000. Our capacity is only 6,600. So we've got a bit of an issue, if you want to see it that way. At the minute, everybody's happy in the industries and things, so we're okay. But we certainly can expand it even more. We could even put in another university somewhere because we've got so many people. But as it goes, we're doing all right. So what I'm just wondering, actually, is this building here, the bookstore, I think we get the full information on this tab over here. Is it the bookstore, attractiveness, land value, the laboratories? Boosts academic work creation. That's the one over here. So at the minute, does it give us like a figure? Oh, that's a library. Where's the laboratories? Aha, found it. Here we go, on the other side of the city. Total academic work chance, 85%. So if we stick another one of these laboratories in somewhere, we should be okay. So over here on the other side of the city, I've just popped in a nice little fountain along with the other buildings that we've got here, looking good. On this little campus area up here, I've just extended it with a path running behind the bus station, and it leads up to some dormitories and a cafeteria. And then the other side of the road over here, remember this roundabout? We do have a cargo terminal over there, but we've actually got some dormitories along here, sort of in the heart of the city at the top end. And I think they fit in really well. Got a nice little area for those. Could we fit in some laboratories around here somewhere? I bet we could if we were a little bit sneaky. We could probably fit them in here. There we go. We've managed to fit it in over here. I think that fits in perfectly well. So let's see whether that just increases it to 100%. That was the university library. That is the wrong building. Darn it. And there we go. That's the university laboratories, whatever you want to say. Let's have a look at that. Oh, now it's 90%. Oh, my goodness me. I want to get that up to 100%. We're going to do it. And with a little finagling just over from this area of the city, I've managed to fit another laboratory in here, which I've hooked up to the walking path that goes all along the quay and over into the city here, which is fantastic. Got the trains running by outside, but they're going to be so busy working on science and things, they are not even going to notice. What has that taken us up to? 95%. So those of you good at maths will know that we can add one more and get 100%. And what I'm doing to try and pick the area I want to put it is looking at my universities and looking at this down here. So graduated low, all the red spots that we've got. So we've got a lot of houses over here by our Orky Borky Mines. We've got these little houses here. So this area down here could probably do with something. I think there's more people living here because these are high density. So if I could just expand my university campus area to this, which will be dead easy, then we could squeeze one in here somewhere. And here we go, right over by our train station, giving access to these guys and girls over here. I just want to check if there is a nearby, well, we've got these trams that drop people off over here, which is absolutely brilliant. We've got the paths now people can walk through. I just wanted to check if there's any bus stops around here that we could slightly adjust. That's our trap. We've got a metro stop right in there. I think we've got access to everything we need. So, yep, I am happy with that. And let's click on here. 100% academic work chance every year, which is great. Let's have a look at our student capacity. 8,350. So, yeah, I think it's time for some lunch. And we'll let this run and get to level 5. So there we go. We have hit the prestigious level, which is absolutely brilliant. We have unlocked everything we can in this area here. So we've now also got the School of Medicine and the School of Science, which will be superb. And we're going to work on adding all of those into our city for sure. So that's going to happen next time. We've done a lot in this episode. Leave a like if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to check out the next one on the screen. The next video, I'm going to be continuing to fix up the second ever city that I built, Centaur City, on the Heavenly Island series. So be sure to subscribe for that. And I will see you all on Thursday for the next video. Take care, everybody. Have a great day. Bye-bye.